Now I have the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Rosa. welcome everybody to this beautiful occasion of love, promise, commitment and sacred vows. My name is John. I'm John Burns and I'm what we call in Ireland an interfaith minister. Basically, without going into it, is I'm licensed by the state to marry all couples wherever they want to get married, in whatever fashion they want to get married, irrespective of who they are. There are two qualifying factors. They have to be over 18, and I'm checking their passports for that one. And they actually have to want to get married, so I think we're good on that one, because they're actually here. Just for a moment, everyone close your eyes and take a few deep breaths and listen. And that is the sound of this country welcoming you here onto its landscape. It's also the voice of God, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, welcoming you all here and welcoming our two beautiful brides. Love has no boundaries. In Irish, Fáilte Caoimhe agus Rebecca, quig an aunt untuk seo, sa lá inniu ann beg quive siri grá. I don't think you'll get that straight away, but what it translates as, very briefly, welcome Caoimhe and Rebecca to this amazing place, and may today be an everlasting memory of love for you both. Because everyone here knows you more than I do, but the one thing I also know is that this isn't starting today. This started a long time ago, this beautiful relationship, this deepening, and today it just goes deeper. And that bit more spiritual. Welcome to this, your wedding day. And just look at where you are right now. And for the beautiful Rebecca, we welcome your proud parents, Tina and Marvin, your sisters, Amanda and Hannah, brothers, Philip and Samuel, also your witness, Rebecca. Did I get all that right? I think I did. And for the beautiful Caoimhe, we welcome your proud parents, Denise and Herbert, your brother Harper, and your witness, Denise. Did I forget anyone? Excellent, good. I usually make a mess of the names. So I always say it doesn't matter because I won't see you guys again. But I'd like to get rebooked by somebody. I want to say also, it's very important to say thank you, Herbert and Marvin, for bringing your beautiful daughters into their wedding day with such obvious pride and love. It is every parent's heart's desire to see their children happy and to find real love in their lives. And this is so true today for Caoimhe and Rebecca. When our children find love and are healthy, we relax. It is the central meaning of life, that our kids are happy and they find someone that loves them. And these two are madly in love. And I can tell you this from the emails and the texts. I'm not going to say which one of those is the over-planner. Because I'm too near the cliff edge. Thanks to Amanda, who is our matron of honour for Rebecca. And a big thank you too to Harper, who is the man of honour for Caoimhe. Nice one. I think the technical term for you, Harper, is broomsmaid. That's right, yeah, broomsmaid. So you can tell them that you were a broomsmaid on an Irish cliff. Nobody is going to have that. Broomsmaid on an Irish cliff. Both you and Amanda there led the entrance just now with a real sense of Parisian flair and panache. Welcome to Liam, just behind you there, who's providing absolutely gorgeous music. And Liam will add a touch of class. Liam's work is absolutely phenomenal. And I urge you later on when you're watching the video to listen. He does fantastic work. Welcome also to Ian, and I think there's so many chauffeurs I've lost track of them. And to our two guys here who are taking the photos and videos. And they will be spectacular. So just let us now all pause, slow down and close our eyes. I invite now the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love now to be here with us on this cliff top and to surround these two amazing women as they stand poised to enter marriage and to deepen their love for each other. We take a moment now to remember all relatives and friends of the Carter and Glover families and friends of our brides who have passed into eternal love. As the sea, as the waves bash against the rocks, as we listen to the call of the seagulls, here today for Rebecca, we especially remember Marvin Glover Sr., Lavron Glover, Byron Madison, and Patricia Mitchell. And for Kaya, we especially remember Paul Harper and Molly Long. And from my heart, as your celebrant, I invite all these gorgeous people to join us now in spirit. Let your minds go there. Let your imagination and your souls accept that. This is what life is. So, let's look at where you are just for a moment. I want everyone to look up here. Do you see that rock? The big bulby one. Over here, this side. This one here. It looks like a head. Right? Can you all look at that for a second? That's Hag's Head. And Hag's Head is a name given to the most southerly point of the Cliffs of Moher here in County Clare, where the cliffs form an unusual rock formation that resembles a woman head looking out to sea. One legend, there's loads of legends about this, and there's one thing about all these legends, they're all lies. You pick whichever one you like, you know. One legend relates how an old witch called Mal fell in love with the Irish hero Cuchulainn. He didn't want anything to do with her, but she chased him all across Ireland. And Cuchulainn, being an Irish hero, escaped by hopping on the sea stacks here and escaped the witch. However, Mal was not as nimble. She lost her footing and was dashed against the cliff. And the formation of the head of the cliff is what they say is Mal looking out to sea, constantly looking for the man she lost. So we have a very different story here today. Two ladies who very much found each other and are very happy to be standing in front of each other. So guys, you're a long way from Bridgewater in Virginia. I did a bit of looked this up. So I think I'd like to visit and take part in, first of all, your summer inn celebration. It's supposed to be very good on Labor Day. And you folks certainly like your parks. You have 13 parks in that place. 13, is there something wrong with you guys? 13 parks covering 99 acres. Again, I would love to see Oakdale. So you have a most beautiful place. So do we. Our first reading is a gorgeous piece, and it's written and going to be read for us by Destiny.
Well, I actually wrote this about one of the legend lies, so thanks for that. I am Koya's cousin, Destiny. And I wrote them a poem today about the city of Kilstyfen, which legend has it that the lost city of Kilstyfen sank under the cliffs of Moher, emerging only when the golden key to its gate is found. And I think we can all agree that Koya and Becca have found their own type of golden city and the love they have for each other. So this is for you guys. Searching for Kilstyfen. I let myself dream of Kilstyfen, and found myself scaling a gritty Shenandoah mountain, brambles and branches blocking me from the key to this golden city. Her hand then did guide me when I dipped my heart in the star-scattered pool for a chance view of Kilstyfen's sacred shores. The mountain, it did cradle and kick, but out the insert I pulled. Hope then was mine that my love would find me home. Now together we scale this cliff to reach a haven where she holds me whole in a city all our own. I love you guys.
Destiny, you wrote that?
I did, yes.
Wow. Isn't that just wonderful? I mean, ladies, she had to research the geography and the history of this place, and you put together the most beautiful piece of poetry. I have to ask you, because I will forget, will you send me this?
I will.
Because, yeah, because I tried to get it out of those two. Forget it.
Get it, yeah.
Well, I'll put it with the file, and then I can send the entire file to them later on.
This one did get wet when I was traveling, so we're lucky I could read off of it.
Okay. Now, ladies, you stand exactly as you are. So I'm going to call on Tina and Jackson to bring forward candles, please. Take a candle each in your hand, please, okay? Stay as you are. God, Father and Mother of light and love, your majesty is evidenced here today by the roaring of waves, the trill of wind over these sacred cliffs, the sound of the seabirds and the sheer glory of this landscape here on the western seaboard of County Clare. Bless these candles of these two amazing women, Rebecca and Kaya. Let your divine light stay in their hearts, reside in their very souls, and let it be seen in their words and actions. Let their individual candles, which they hold now over your sacred landscape, let these candles represent in your eyes their uniqueness as they travel into sacred marriage under your divine protection, keeping them safe, ever loved and permanent. Great God of inclusivity and diversity, we give thanks to all those who fought so long and so hard for equal rights for all couples to get married. We honour those people who showed us the way of true love and commitment and have chosen marriage as an expression of their love. God does not put up barriers to who can love who. Love is unconditional. And here we have two beautiful women stepping forward in marriage. Love is the only thing that makes sense in the face of so many burdens piled on our backs, as we turn to each other for support and the caring connection that lifts our spirits. Now give each other a kiss, and I'll take the candles off you. Thank you very much. Now, I told you I'd get theatrical, didn't I? And I'm going to ask Denise to bring forward the centre candle. You take this together and you hold this up together. This is centre, please. Give me a kiss and a hug. As high as you can. So they hold their unity candle together, given to them now by Denise, and thank you, Denise. This represents these two ladies moving forward now as we rather than I. And just for a moment, you might just make your own private wish or prayer for them, because that's what they're doing now. Thank you, Liam. Our second piece of reading is the gorgeous Apache wedding poem, going to be read for us by Amanda.
Me?
Yeah. Is it Amanda?
Do I have it?
I have it. So you practice it, right?
Okay, thank you.
Now, 1 second, I'm just get the microphone. Can you hold that as well?
Okay. All right. The Apache Wedding Poem. Now you will feel no storms, for each of you will be shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no loneliness, for each of you is companion to the other. You are two persons, but there is one life before you and one home. Turn together to look at the road you traveled to reach this, the hour of your happiness. It stretches behind you into the past. Look to the future that lies ahead, a long and winding adventure-filled road, whose every turn means discovery, new hopes, new joys, new laughter, and a few shared tears. May happiness be your companion. May beauty surround you both on the journey ahead and through all the years to come. Go this day to your dwelling place and enter into your days together. May your days be good and long upon the earth. Your adventure has just begun.
Well done. Round of applause, I think, for Amanda. It's not easy to read. It's quite emotional, isn't it? Now, I'm going to ask for your help. Would you hold this for me? Thank you. Now, can we all gather a little closer, please? Thank you very much. Eyes closed. These are the hands of your best friend, Kaya and Rebecca, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands of Kaya that will work alongside yours, Rebecca, as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. And these are the hands that will countless times wipe tears from your eyes, sometimes tears of sorrow, for that's part of life, but many more tears of joy. These are the hands of Rebecca and Kaya that will tenderly help to hold your family and friends as one. Kaya, squeeze these hands. These are the hands of Rebecca, your wife-to-be and life partner, which will be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Rebecca, squeeze these hands. These are the hands of the beautiful and magnificent Kaya, who you will call your wife. She will be your shield and anchor as you both walk through life in love and into a beautiful marriage. Kaya and Rebecca, you are meant to be together, and today celebrates this reality in a new way. May your marriage be blessed with health, joy, much laughter, mm-hmm. and success. I'm going to tip it, take it off, and give each other a kiss. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Just a cute kiss.
Well, I'd go for it.
No, not yet.
But you could. Thank you.
That's fantastic.
Thank you. Goodbye. Thanks for your help. Now. Stay holding hands. That's nice. I need to get my glasses. This is where I admit my increasing decrepitude. Isn't it beautiful here?
It's
we don't get this. We don't get this.
It's
usually full of bugs. So just a story about our couple. And the story came from Becca, so you can blame her. Our first date was a Cuban restaurant, followed by gelato and a projector screen with the Little Rascals movie. I found out much later The gelato place we went to on our first date used to be a ring shop, whereas Coya's grandfather bought her mother's or grandmother's wedding ring. There we go. A few dates in, she discovered I could cook, and I discovered she could make a fairly decent mac and cheese. I helped her learn softball. She joined our church league team and also taught her the importance of not always having a plan. Welcome to an Irish wedding. She taught me her love of music by playing me songs on the guitar and drums and the importance of keeping a schedule and an organised home. Both of us love travelling and trying new foods and new adventures, including learning how to make homemade pasta, creme brulee, macaroons and a lot of other fun treats and travelling to several states together. You got to go to their house for dinner. That's not fair to do that right here now. One of our favourite things is surprising each other, and it's become sort of like a game. She would surprise me with a gift of activity, and I would get her back the next month. She totally beat me when we went to Alaska and she proposed right next to a glacier. That lovely? Oh, come on.
It was epic.
That's fantastic. We've been through ups, like moving into our brand new home, and downs with the loss of several very important and influential people in our lives. And I just paused there today when I was reading it. The great thing you did at the start of your wedding ceremony by mentioning those people was absolutely magnificent. That was magnificent. I think one of our favourite moments together was our trip to Seattle, where we almost drove to the top of Mount Rainier even without knowing it. We kept looking out the window for Mount Rainier. The road turned into icy snow and we had to back down it for a while. We ended up having to do a 50-point turn around so we would not drive off the edge of the mountain and found the end of the rainbow at the bottom of the mountain. Normally, this is where a guy can say something about women's driving skills, but I'm not going to do that. One time we drove to a dark national park where you're supposed to see the stars the best they are. We loaded the car with snacks to make in the campfire, tons of delicious campfire food. We unpacked our tent in the pouring rain. It was late, it was dark. The tent dripped the whole night. It was still raining when we woke up and they were supposed to provide wood. All they provided was two pieces of wood. They were completely soaked from all the rain. We ate a candy bar and drove 2.5 hours back home. My God, these girls are not classy, are they? No. We ended up making all the food just in the oven instead of over a campfire. Wasn't that fantastic? Thank you for that.
I'm not allowed to plan anything.
That's a fantastic story. Now our couple are going to stand and face each other and make their vows to each other.
These are my vows to you. When you fight for something, you know it's special. We didn't get here overnight, but it's worth it every day. I'm so proud of who you have become over the years, and I feel so honored that I'll get to call you my wife. I promise to love you and never take you for granted. I promise to never give up hope. I promise to have faith in our marriage and each other. I promise to stand by your side through whatever comes our way. I promise to put you first and be your best friend. I promise to be the best version of myself for you. I love you.
Coya, my first, last, and only love. I promise to make you smile and laugh every day. I promise to feed you before you even get hungry. I promise to take you dancing even if you're not sad. I promise to hold you when you feel alone. I promise to keep you hydrated and rested when you're sick. I promise to love you when you're grouchy. I promise to love you in every moment like it's my last. I promise to hold your hand while the world falls apart. I promise to be there for you through it all. I promise to go on adventures with you. I promise to support all of your hobbies and take care of Gus the goat too. I promise to make you all the desserts and snacks. Coy, I promise you my whole heart until the end of time, my love.
A round of applause, folks, I think. Okay, dear family and friends, as I say, it's time to seal the deal. And can I ask all your friends and family who earlier volunteered to block the exits that now is your time to do that? This is our last chance. Are there any persons here present who knows of any reason why Kaya and Rebecca ought not to enter into a legal contract of marriage, should speak now or forever hold their peace? Anyone who talks doesn't get their dinner. It's a little boat. Kaya, do you come here freely with the intention to be married to Rebecca? Do you hereby state that you've read and understood the list of civil impediments to marriage, and do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or any other legal barrier to your proposed marriage to Rebecca?
I do. I do.
Rebecca, do you come here freely with the intention of being married to Kaya?
Yes.
I do.
I do.
Do you hereby state that you've read and understood the list of civil impediments to marriage, and do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or any other or any other legal barrier to your proposed marriage to Kaya?
I do.
Okay. Okay, we're good. We're good so far. At the end of the next piece, you both say together, "We are," really loudly. Okay? It is now that I move to declare and legalise your marriage according to the laws of this state and the powers vested in me. In doing so, it's my duty to remind you now publicly of the serious and binding nature of the relationship you're about to enter. Marriage is a full and voluntary commitment of two people to each other, to the exclusion of all others, and it is entered into with the desire, the hope and the firm intention that it will last for a lifetime. In the presence of the Almighty, in the presence of your family and friends, are you happy to proceed?
We are.
Good. I think that's fairly okay, isn't it? We're good to go. Okay. Kaya, please face Rebecca and repeat after me. I, Kaya Carter,
take you,
Rebecca Glover, to be my faithfully wedded wife,
for as long as we live.
I will keep you and hold you. Comfort and tend you.
Protect you and shelter you.
All the days of our lives. And can I call on, 1 minute now, can I call on Tina for the rings, please? So, Rebecca, will you now please Kaya, will you please place Rebecca's wedding ring on her finger now, please? And also look at the camera. Rebecca, please face Kaya and repeat after me. I.
What about the other one?
The other one, yeah.
Both of
them? Perfect. So, Rebecca, please face Kaya and repeat after me. I.
Rebecca Glover.
Take you.
Kaya Carter.
To be my faithfully wedded wife. For as long as we live. I will keep you and hold you. Comfort and tend you.
Protect you and shelter you.
All the days of our lives. And Rebecca, will you now please place Kaya's wedding ring on her finger? Look at the camera. Now hold each other's hands nice and tightly. Now you better guys get this part right. Rebecca and Kaya have now declared before us all that they will live together in marriage, and this has been symbolised by the joining of hands, the joy of light, the exchange of vows and rings, the presence of these beautiful people right behind you. At this point in our ceremony, and with boundless joy, I can now pronounce you wife and wife. Well done.
May I kiss my bride?
Yes, you may indeed. I'd like you to hold each other in an embrace. until I say not to. A little reflection for our couple. Destiny is a mysterious thing. No matter what you do or where you go, you cannot avoid it. And no matter how hard you try, even putting forth your greatest effort, you cannot force it to happen before it's time. This occasion that we witness today is the destiny of two souls. There is not a force in the universe that could have kept you apart, and there is nothing that could have brought you together any sooner. Each of you had your lives to live, lives that were stepping stones that have led to this moment in time, this stunning uniting of hearts and minds. This occasion we witness today is the destiny of two souls, Kaya and Rebecca. Yes, destiny is a marvellous and mysterious thing. May it take you on many more journeys of excitement and fun. We have two little pieces left. One is where I'm going to read out something that was sent to me by both brides, and they haven't seen the answer to it. The second one is, second part is, we're going to sign our legal papers at this table. And then they are, they're done, they're cooked.
Right now we're medium rare.
This morning I sent a text to both. I asked what one meant to the other, and they haven't seen it. So, Rebecca, what does Kaya mean to you? Kaya is my calm, my comfort, my joy, and my love. Being hers makes all my insecurities vanish, and I feel safe in her arms. She knows how I feel even before I say it. She makes my happiness and safety her first priority and makes me feel like I'm the only one in the room. She knows how to make me laugh, how to cheer me up when I'm feeling down. She would do anything for me. Kaya is my world. I know people say that, but I really mean it. Kaya makes life magical, and I feel like I'm living a fairy tale with her no matter what each day has to offer. I really do not know how I lived without her for so long. But now that I have her, I will never let her go. Isn't that lovely? And I asked Kaya what Rebecca meant to you. And it was fun getting these because I got parts of them by email, parts by WhatsApp and part by text. So we put it all together. Becca means the world to me. I would do anything to make her happy. This morning felt for me like Christmas morning by a million times. So much excitement for our big day. Without a doubt in my mind, I know she's the person I'm supposed to spend my life with. She's gotten me through ups and downs and is always by my side. She's my best friend and my happy place. She calms me when I feel anxious by just being near me. She's such a beautiful person inside and out. She's compassionate, loving, intelligent, not to mention an excellent cook. She's all things good wrapped into one. She's my dream girl, and I can't wait to marry her. And we're delighted to say that that wait is now over. So our couple will go and sign their paperwork, which I'll just get for you now. Okay, let's hear how loud you guys can get. They're now legally married. And just to say, before our ceremonies has concluded, just to say, as your celebrant, it was a massive honour to have been asked and chosen to do so. I found working with both of you good fun. Good fun. And today was meant to happen at this exact time.
Yeah.
Nothing was late. We're fine. Look at where we are. So you two have a great time, have a great marriage, love and health, and never stop saying I love you to each other, morning and night. That's all I ask you to do. And the rest of you, get extremely drunk. You're in Ireland.
Excellent advice.
Have a great day, folks.
Yeah. gonna change. I can never walk away. Yeah, she's my baby, my whole world. She ain't my blood, but she's mine. She's my girl. They hit me like a train.
So I dance with myself.